46, and here we will discuss about estimation of a random vector. So before going to discuss about estimation of a random vector, I will talk about first estimation of a random variable, that means with a given observation. We had already discussed that in prior. So I will talk about from the linear model perspective, how to what happens, simplest model structure in order to estimate a signal or any kind of unknown things what you want to estimate. Generally we put a linear model structure, and if someone is saying that why we are putting a linear model structure, then your answer would it would rely on central limit theorem, or simply you can say that if you talk sample size in large as a large, then simply every distribution can be approximated by a normal distribution due to central limit theorem. So based on that, you can say that generally we proceed with the distribution of response variable or distribution of what we call it noise. What we always, if you are talking about data happens to be a noisy measurement of anything what you want to estimate. So noisy measurement, generally noise what we are taking, then generally we are calling it error, and that happens to be normally distributed. That's why if you take a normal model, normal Gaussian model, then the corresponding process of estimating the unknown parameter, it is taking the form of linear model. And I had already mentioned that the efficient model, efficient estimator of an unknown parameter, it is given by conditional expectation. That conditioning we are putting over the observation. So conditional expectation, why? Because conditional expectation, if you proceed with that, with a given observation y, then it happens to be that you had already seen that if you are taking, suppose x is the known quantity that you want to estimate, you don't have explicit information about x. What you do in place of x, you come up with one observation y. That one is entirely dependent on x. That means x, y is containing the information of x. That means you can simply say that y is what it is, one kind of measurement of x, or simply you can say that y is a function of x in short, or you can say that it also contains some amount of noise. So noise generally we denote it by capital E, or you can give another notation like that way. So that situation is coming here. Or in simple, you can say that noise is additive. This observation y is additive, containing a signal plus additive noise. Or there are two kind of noise. One is white noise. Okay, that means if you talk about in the distribution of white noise, and then simply if suppose it is a multivariate, then it would be what zero mean with this is the covariance matrix, white covariance matrix what we are calling it. Otherwise also W might be a colored noise. So colored in case of colored noise, the covariance matrix of W, it would be non-identity. It would be some positive definite matrix C. So this we are calling it colored noise. So C, intentionally we are taking notation for covariance matrix of W. Okay. So those are colored noise. So several times those things will come. So here Y is an observation of X, which contains signal as well as additivity noise. Okay. So here our intention is that we have to estimate X with given observation y. So there are various estimation process, likelihood estimation, least square estimation, then map estimation. There are various. Okay, among them we try to sort out that which one is the best estimator, or which one is the efficient. Best means efficient estimator. Then you will see that the conditional expectation of x given y, it is talking about the efficient estimator of x under the observation y. Why? Because if you are willing to find mean square error with respect to this estimator, if you define mean square error, then that happens to be the least mean square error. That means how you find mean square error, this is the estimate of x, so you can say that it is what it is, x hat, you can denote it x hat. So how we define mean square error, we subtract this estimate from x, that we are calling it estimation error, and after that we are taking a square. Okay, we are taking a square. After that we are taking mean or expectation, then we are getting mean square error. Okay, so this mean square error is what it is least in case of your if you are proceeding with conditional expectation. If you are proceeding with conditional expectation, then this mean square error is the least value. That's why we had I had already discussed several ways to establish that conditional expectation is giving the least mean square error. So that's why this estimate is the most efficient estimate of x. Most efficient estimate. Okay, so that I had already discussed in last class. And why? Because this one is having the least mean square error. That's why it is the most efficient. That means most efficient. And also you can define efficiency through various way. How we define efficiency? Because if you are taking any model, then you always have to come up with efficiency. So what is the efficiency? Whatever estimator of x you come up with, then what you do, divide that estimator of x here, take in denominator. So that estimator of x denoted x bar, and what is the best estimator? It would be this is the best estimator. Then simply question would come, what is the variance of this best estimator? So it would be given by Kramer-Rau lower bound. So simply that one is related with 1 by information matrix, Fisher information matrix. Information matrix with respect to unknown, this one. Okay, so just to find this, this one is talking about efficiency. So value of this one, we always see that if you talk about variance of any estimate, it would be, if you suppose, so it would be what? It would be bounded below by 1 plus bias square of the corresponding estimator divided by Fisher information matrix. Okay, Fisher information matrix. So this is the lower bound provided by that. Suppose you come up with the idea that this estimator is unbiased, then in that case this bias, if it is unbiased, then this would be zero. So that's why in that case, if bias is zero in case of unbiased estimator, then what would be the lower bound? Lower bound simply it would be 1 by Fisher matrix, Fisher information matrix. So that's why this is the what, this is the value taken by unbiased and efficient estimator, or this is the best bound, best lower bound, what we are saying that. So it is the best, we can't go below this one. This is the greatest upper bound of variance of any estimator. So with respect to that, we are defining efficiency. So we always compare. So it is coming in term of relative sense. So that's why we can say that maximum value of this one would be 1 in when x hat happens to be unbiased and efficient estimator. Otherwise, it would be less than 1. Okay, so that's way. Sometimes people are saying that it is efficiency is very much related with what we call it, how much accuracy. It is related with accuracy and other kind of. You can relate efficiency with accuracy as well for a estimator, and there are very good relation. You can see all those things. So I'm just trying to go to discuss about that linear model structure through which we will try to estimate a random vector. So just here I'm coming directly to linear estimator with least mean square error of a unknown random variable x. Unknown random variable x. So how we can find this? So we are going to estimate a random variable which will have, that the estimator will have least mean square. error. So we will here introduce one model structure. So suppose x is an unknown random variable whose value we want to estimate. Okay, under the observation of y, and we are putting a linear model structure linear model structure of the conditional expectation. I told that this conditional expectation is providing one estimator of x. Among them, various estimator. You had already seen that maximum likelihood estimator. Then you had already seen that least square estimator. Then you had already seen that maximum posteriori estimator. This one is the Bayesian approach. Okay. Then we are discussing about mean square estimation. Okay, mean square estimation. Okay, so among all these, you will see that this is the estimator which is having the least mean square error. Okay, and suppose conditional expectation, it may be a linear or nonlinear function of x, but we can put a structure over this one. Suppose it is a linear function with respect to parameter. This parameter, it is a linear function with respect to parameter, also it is linear with respect to observation as well. So if you are putting such kind of condition, then this condition we are calling it linear model. That means we are putting a linear structure. Then obvious question would come that why we are taking a linear function, conditional expectation as a linear function of observation. Why? Because here also in parameter, it is coming because of the normal nature of that. That if suppose x, that unknown quantity, and y, the observed quantity, if jointly these two are having joint normal distribution as a joint distribution, in that case, if you try to find conditional expectation of x given y, that would be always a linear function of y. You can verify it. So if you are taking a joint distribution of x and y as a normal distribution or bivariate Gaussian distribution, you will see that if you try to find conditional expectation, that would be a linear function. That's why here by default we are assuming that our sample size would be very large. That's why conditional expectation would have a linear structure with respect to y, also as a linear function. Okay, linear with respect to y, that means y is the argument of this conditional expectation, and omega 1 and omega naught, these are identifying the function. So that's why we are saying that a linear model coming with respect to omega, and argument y, it is coming, argument is y here, that is, it is function of y, but function is defined by or identified by omega. Okay, so it is a linear structure, linear model with linear argument. So that approach is coming. So we have taken this as a hypothetical function, what we can say further. So we will try to get an explicit, we need to compute here omega naught, omega 1 and omega naught. What would be that in term of x and y, or in term of y generally? So we want to compute this. So it is very simple to compute this one. What you do, apply the previous idea of law of iterative expectation. What you do, apply expectation throughout in this linear model, then you will see that expectation of conditional expectation happens to be equal to the expectation of x. Okay, it is directly coming from law of iterative expectation. Okay, very simple to I might have discussed proof of this one. So from there you can easily deduce this relation. And in right hand side, just what we do, we have applied expectation both sides. So that's why omega 1, it is what we are applying expectation. Y is random variable, omega is not a random variable, it is just trying to identify the function. So that's why omega 1, it will come out of the expectation, and only we will have expectation of y. And omega naught is not here, in this term there is no random variable. So simply what is the expectation of a real number, it would be the number itself. Okay, so that's where we are getting this representation, that expectation of x equal to omega 1 plus expectation of y plus omega naught. From here, we can write omega naught in term of expectation of x and expectation of y, and we will substitute back that in equation 1. After that, what we see? We see that conditional expectation is written as in term of expectation of x and y and expectation of y with only one parameter. So we are having one equation and one unknown omega 1. So actually we can identify or we can compute omega 1 from this equation itself. So we have to do further modification and further concept we need to introduce in order to compute omega 1. So here remember that our idea is that we try to compute omega naught and omega 1. So our task is that we need to compute omega 1. Once we will able to compute omega 1, we will substitute in this equation and we will get omega naught as well. So just let us try to compute omega 1. So how we can compute omega 1? So we will do various process here. One process what we do, we multiply this linear model 1 throughout both sides with y. Okay. After that, we are taking expectation. So here we multiply with, here what we do in this, we are multiplying with y both sides. After that, we are taking expectation. Okay, so if you are doing that process, so what will happen? So this expectation, again through law of iterative expectation, it would be what? It would be just expectation of x and y. It would be, if after simplification, it will take this form. Very simple to reduce it. And in right hand side, what we will observe, that we have multiplied both side with y. So here omega naught into y, and here it would be omega 1 into y square. So that's where omega naught, so here also we are applying expectation. So omega naught into expectation of y plus omega 1 into expectation of y square. Y, we had multiplied y both sides, that's where y into y, y square it would be, and that's where we are getting this representation 1. Now we will do one more thing, is that here we had already seen that expectation of x can be written in this form due to this simplification. Due to that, here we had applied expectation both sides. Through that, we got this structure due to law of iterative expectation. And from here, what we do? Here we are multiplying expectation of y both sides. Just we are multiplying expectation of y both sides. We are not doing any other operation, just we are multiplying. Here in this equation, we are multiplying expectation of x both sides. Due to that, what we are getting? We are getting this representation. So we will take benefit of this equation and this equation. You can call this equation number 3. Equation number 3. This you can call it equation 2. This here 2, I have, you call it 3. And let us call this equation 4. We'll utilize all these, and this one is equation 5. So we are having all these equations. So from here, what we see here, we recall the covariance of any two random variable x and y. If you are having two random variable x and y, we can talk about covariability between those two. So how we define covariance between x and y? It is defined like this way: expectation of product of those two random variable minus product of corresponding expectation of random variable or mean. So simply it is very much clear definition of covariance. Okay, so here we can get this value from this equation 4. We can substitute this value from equation 4, and this value we can get it from equation 5. And after substituting all this value, so what would be here? This omega naught times expectation of y, omega naught times expectation of y. Both are common here, also here, and we are doing subtraction of this one from subtraction of this one from this one. So this term will cancel out. Only we will have this term and this term. And here in both term, omega 1 is what? It is common. So we are taking common omega 1. So what is the factor term here? In the bracket, we observe expectation of y square minus square of expectation of y. Now what does it talk about? It is actually definition of the variance of y. If you explore the definition of variance of any random variable, how it is expanded, It is actually defined like this way. Expectation of y, expectation of square of mean deviation of y. So this is the definition of variance, and if you expand it, then it is taking the form expectation of y square minus expectation of square of expectation of y. So that's way this term is nothing, it is talking about variance of y. So we can easily see that omega 1 can be computed as a ratio of covariance of x, that the unknown quantity that we want to estimate, and the observed quantity through which we are trying to observe x, divided by variance of the observed quantity. So here, if you know the joint distribution of x and y, and if you know the, definitely we will have idea of distribution of x, so easily we can, there would be no issue, okay. And also we can, if we come up with one prior distribution of x, through that we can compute this quantity, okay. And once we are able to compute this quantity omega 1, we can substitute back here in equation 2 in order to get value of omega naught, and hence we will see conditional expectation in the as a linear function like this way, with known value of omega naught and omega 1, we will get an explicit representation of the linear model. So that is the approach in order to estimate a non-random variable with non-observation with least mean square error. That is the approach. So here simply I would like to take one example, that we are talking here estimating a signal with least mean square error. So here least mean square error will come here. So here suppose x is the signal which is transmitted from one transmitter to receiver, but receiver is observing a noisy signal y, or you can say that y is the observation. So this y contains signal, apart from signal there is a noise w. Okay, this is the observed signal, what, or noisy signal, you can say that both are same, observed signal, noisy signal, all are same, okay. So the noisy signal or observed signal would have two component, one component x that happens to be signal component, and another component w that happens to be, simply I am taking it here, white noise. So white noise, or simply noise you can call it, okay. And further, what are the given to us, we are having information that x is coming from transmitter and w is coming from system. So both source of x and w both are different, so we can't talk about dependency between x and w, because both are coming from different sources. So there is no dependency. Definitely x and y would be independent to each other, it won't affect. So it is very much simple that two person are coming from different background, simply we can't talk about dependency between those two. So that situation is coming here like this way. So here so we can further say that x and w would be uncorrelated. That means if you try to find covariance between x and w, that would be zero, because both are coming from different source. Okay, so now further information is given that we know that somehow from past experience there is a x is having variance sigma square x, that one is the variance of x. So from the past experience we have collected this one, okay. Also we know the variance of noise, that one is sigma square w, that is the variance of noise. Both things we know that from the past experience, or somehow through expertise we come up with those variance, okay. So our intention is that we have to estimate the signal x. So through what process we want to estimate? We are not going to apply likelihood estimation approach, least square estimation approach, or maximum posterior estimation approach. What approach we will do? We will come up with conditional expectation approach. That why? Because that one is giving least square error. So that's why we are coming with least mean square error. So that's why we try to estimate x through that approach. Okay. So what linear model I had already derived, we will use that derivation of linear model in order to estimate the signal x. What kind of form it will take? It will take the form that conditional expectation can be written as expectation of x plus omega 1 times observation minus expectation of the observation. This y the observation what we are observing. Okay, and expectation definitely we can come up with one some kind of sample measurement we come up with or this might be given. Okay. It may possible this might be given. Okay, so here what we do, what was the omega 1? We had already seen that it is actually it is computed. If you know the joint distribution of x and y, also y is observation, so definitely we will have some idea of distribution of y. We can easily, or otherwise we can proceed with the prior distribution of x, and through that we can easily compute omega 1. That happens to be ratio of covariance of x and y with variance of y. So everything is computable here, and substitute back all these things, we see that conditional expectation of x given y as a estimate of x can be written in this form. In this way we can compute. This one is one example of what signal, also you can say that signal detection or signal estimation. So this one is simply a signal estimation problem. So here we try to estimate further one concrete formula of this one. What would be that? From the question it is already given that variance of x, that signal, it happens to be sigma square x, and variance of noise is sigma square w. So we will take benefit of those and we will try to calculate variance of y. Y is what? It is actually noisy measurement of x, so that's why y would be x plus w. And if you try to take properties of two independent random variable, if you try to find variance of two independent random variable, it would be just sum of corresponding variances. So that's why variance of y would be what? Sum of variance of x and variance of w. So easily we got the variance of y. Likewise, also we try to calculate covariance of x and y from the given data. Okay. So covariance of x and y means what? It is talking about covariance of x and x plus w. Okay, and that means further, if you break it in further form, it is talking about just what covariance of x and w plus variance of x, if you try to break it. But what we know that covariance of x is what? X and w is both are uncorrelated. So this quantity is zero. So simply covariance of x and y would be what? Variance of x, and that one is given to sigma square. And substitute back all those and we will have a explicit form of estimate of x with least mean square error. What is that? So here we are getting an absolute representation of this estimate of x as an efficient or best estimate of x, we can say that. So what is that? It is expectation of x plus omega 1, it would be what? Covariance of x, covariance of x and y that we had already computed, it would be sigma square x divided by variance of y, that happens to be sum of variance of x and variance of noise w into y minus expectation square. This is the formula for estimating x, which will have the least mean square error. We are having this one. Okay. So another, there is one more approach to estimate the unknown quantity. What is that? That we are that unknown quantity. That means it. How we can come up with omega naught and omega 1. Directly we can, if we know the joint distribution of x and y, then easily we can compute omega naught and omega 1. But suppose we don't know the joint distribution of x and y, so what we have to do? We have to go for sampling approach. That means here we try to estimate omega naught and omega 1 through method of moment. This one is another technique to estimate omega naught and omega 1 in the linear model of structure. So we are going to talk about that. So the value of various moment, we had already seen in the definition of or in the derivation of this linear model, what was omega 1 It was covariance of x, the signal we want or the quantity we want to estimate, divided by variance of y. Okay, and omega 1 was, omega naught was involving expectation of x and expectation of y. So you can, easily we can say that here in the computation process of omega naught and omega 1, variance happens to be second, it can be related with second order moment, and covariance also it can be related with second order moment, and omega naught contains first order and second order moment both. First order happens to be mean and second order is related with variance of covariance. So we can simply say that in the computational process of omega naught and omega 1, both are expressed in term of first and second moment. So what we do, if distribution is not given to us, joint distribution of x and y is not given to us, so what we do, we can come up with the estimate of those moments through method of moment. So what does this do? Suppose we are having a sample of size n of x and y like this way. X happens to be the signal which we want to estimate, and y is the observation of x. So suppose this is the sample what we have given. So sample xi is given with observation yi. Okay, then the what concept of empirical formula we can come up with sample moment. How we can come up with sample moment? So first order moment we can estimate it through sample mean. First order moment is what? It is just expectation of the corresponding random variable. Okay, so we try to estimate this expectation through sample mean, and sample mean of expectation of, we try to estimate expectation of x by sample mean of x, expectation of y by sample mean of y. So all these are first order moment, or corresponding sample mean happens to be empirical or estimate. Okay, likewise also we can come up with estimate of second order moment. So here second order moment of x would be expectation of x square. So we don't know the distribution of x, so how we can compute this expectation? It is very difficult. So we can come up with one empirical approach to calculate to estimate this second order moment through this sample variance. So this simply we can call it is again a sample moment, second order moment also you can call it. Likewise also you can come up with second order moment, estimate of second order moment of y as well, and estimate of covariance, estimate of covariance of x and y. So all these are formula, very simple kind of formula we can see. So using these concept we can estimate omega naught and omega 1 like this way. So omega 1 again it would be what? It is defining what? Sample covariance of x and y. It is defining sample variance of x and y. So easily we can, through that sample approach, we can come up with estimate of omega 1. Once we are getting estimate of omega 1, we can substitute that in the that linear hypothetical function, and we will get back our omega, estimate of omega naught. Okay, one more thing, that we are taking linear model like this way. It is linear function. So if you we had already seen that through it law of iterated approach, a mean lies in the line. Okay, in that due to linear model we are getting linear structure. So mean of x and y both lie in the linear model, in the linear curve structure, linear function, simply you can say that. So it lies, that's why through that we can easily get estimate of omega naught hat. Now next we will talk about linear estimate of a random vector with least mean square error. So it is just what we do, we can generalize the previous case of single random variable to random vector. So here x would be just a random factor. Okay, so here we are taking, so if when you are taking x as a random factor, so here conditional expectation would be also a random factor, and it is coming like in this scenario here, x is a random factor, it may have p number of attribute. First attribute, second attribute, likewise it may go up to xp, p number of attribute. Here remember that little bit change. So what you do here, you can estimate it through this linear formula, and all about that you have to identify what is the this matrix W and what is this B vector. So you want to estimate these two. So again the same process, apply it, and you will see that directly I will go same process. Process is similar what we for univariate random variable you had taken. In the similar fashion we can come up with estimate of W. Directly I will write discuss here. What is the estimate of W? It is the what it is talking about, ratio of covariance of x and y. Remember that x is here random vector, y is also a random vector. When we are defining covariance of two random vector, it is not simply covariance, it is we are calling it cross covariance. So this term you can call it cross covariance. Cross covariance. Okay. And what is this one? This one is talking about covariance between two random vector. Remember that x and y, here x and y happens to be random vectors. X is a random vector. The corresponding observation of x would be also a random vector. So that's where we come up with covariance of a random vector with itself. So it would be simply we can call it is a covariance. Here covariance, simply we can call it, this would be cross covariance, it would be covariance function. So through that we can get value of W. We will substitute back here, and in order to get value of B here, we can substitute back here and we will get value of B. So this is the process to estimate what we call it random vector through linear structure. Okay, so it is already above 45 minutes, and anyone is having any question you can ask, and this is the end of this course. If you are willing to ask any question, you are